The Philippine Sweepstakes Office admits to altering the photo of a winner who took home around 690 million pesos in a recent Lotto draw. PCSO General Manager Mel Robles made that decision during a Senate inquiry by the Ways and Means Committee. Senator Rafi Tulfo presented the photo during the hearing amid allegations the winner was not a real bettor, but someone who invested in the PCSO. Robles maintains they edited the photo to conceal the winner's identity.
We have to protect the identity of the winner. Meron po nagreklamo sa amin one time, we covered the face, eh yung damit naman po ay nakilala. So, nagreklamo siya, sana naman daw po, wag ipakita naman po yung damit. So, yan po ang reason niya, and I agree, it's a very poor editing, pero the objective is to conceal the clothing na ma-identify sa kanya.
La Trinidad down in Benguet logs a temperature of 10.8 degrees Celsius this morning. That's the lowest this northeast monsoon or Amihan season. Metro Manila also recorded its coldest temperature this year at 20.1 degrees Celsius in Quezon City this morning. Temperatures below 20 degrees Celsius were also logged in Batanes, Aurora, and other areas in Luzon. Baguio City still holds the country's all-time record for the lowest temperature at 6.3 degrees on January 18, 1961. Let's get the latest from Davao del Norte. We are joined by Fe Maestre, head of the Information Office of Davao de Oro. Thanks for making time for our program, Fe.
Yes, good afternoon, ma'am.
All right, Fe, what is the latest situation in your province? How many people have been affected by the landslides and the torrential rains in the area?
Yes, ma'am. Actually, do I to speak English or in Tagalog po?
Sige, go ahead.
Okay. Yes, ma'am. Actually, we have about 8,599 families affected. That's overall the 11 municipalities of Davao de Oro. If we translate that into individuals, we have about 32,214 individuals. Now, sa ating mga evacuation centers, we have about 3,195 families na po sa ating mga evacuation centers. Again, that's around almost all of the municipalities in Davao de Oro. And for now, our focus is on the giving of relief operations to different municipalities. Actually, we already have several relief operations since 16, 17, and today. Again, unfortunately, the weather today is cloudy. Earlier po, may mga pag-ulan. So expect the reports from the ground. And so meron, dahil nga hindi pa tumila yung ulan, we still have reports of landslide, no? From the different parts of the barangay sa Davao de Oro po.
Fel, let's first talk about the casualties. Our last count so far, 7 dead, 2 injured, and 10 missing due to the landslide. Tumaas na ba yung bilang na ito? Dumami na ba yung mga namatay o nasugatan o nawawala dahil sa kalamidad?
Actually, ma'am, as we are speaking, kanila lang po namin na-receive pang report, and we just had our press conference. You can watch it on our Davao de Oro Facebook page. Now, as to the number, the exact number of the details in the Mungkayo incident landslide, we have yet to receive an official report, but I would be glad to get back to you as soon as we have the report, the official report from the Mungkayo po.
All right, still 7 dead so far. We're hoping that number would not increase in the next few hours or in the coming days. What kinds of assistance is the government extending for the affected families of these people who died due to the landslide?
What kind of assistance po, ma'am? Did they get it right?
Apo, apo.
Most probably, our government is into it. So, again, I have yet to give you the update as to what kind of assistance. But surely, the sure thing is we are ready to assist the affected families.
All right. Fe, how likely is it for the government to declare a state of calamity in Davao de Oro?
Yes, actually, the governor has stated earlier, since wala pa po tayong nag-declare ng munisipyo na nag-declare ng state of calamity, that's one of the one of those that we have to consider, one of the factors. So mga dalawa that's two or more municipalities that will declare that the province will declare the state of calamity po. But so far, wala pa pong nag-declare sa mga munisipyo.
How about the status of your calamity fund so far? How much is left in your coffers with regard to your calamity fund?
Yes, ma'am. Actually, I have yet. I don't have the exact figures, but I will get back to you again for the exact amount. But yes, we have started for the relief operations.
All right. It's still January. Fresh funds coming in from Congress. I'm pretty sure hindi pa depleted as of the moment yung calamity fund, since, as mentioned, it's just January, the start of the year. But how soon would you say that Davao de Oro is still capable of addressing the situation on its own? Or would you say that you need the national government to come in and intervene anytime soon?
With the Ardana, we have yet to receive all from the collated reports from the municipalities. But for now, the PDRM is on top of it, and we can still be able to handle the situation. But then again, we have yet to get all the collated damages in infrastructure and agriculture.
All right. And we will get back to you, Fe, as soon as you have more information for us. Thank you so much for joining us this afternoon, Fe Maestre from the Davao de Oro Information Office.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Tragedy in southern Philippines. A landslide in a mining area in Davao de Oro province kills 7 people and injures 2 others. 10 people are still missing. Authorities in the town of Mungkayo have temporarily halted search and rescue efforts due to fears of another landslide. Authorities blamed the landslide on incessant rains due to the shear-line weather system. Non-stop rains have battered the Davao and eastern Mindanao region since Monday. In Tagum City, Davao del Norte, the national road remains unpassable to light vehicles due to the floods. Other towns in the province remain submerged in the floodwaters. The flooding has affected around 46,000 families. Local governments now studying whether to declare a state of calamity.